We're doing the translation.
Okay.
The journalist putting the
recording devices down.
That's right, yeah. How nice
it will be translation as well.
Check
for this one. So you may have to do your Richard Gordon and fill in as best you can, but here comes Gordon Strachan. Just scribbling furiously at the moment. Gordon, can we just start by your view on the game and perhaps your reaction when that ball hit the back of the net?
I think we've seen it. But at no time did it feel really stressful when I was down there, because I felt part of it when I was down there, and I could see that they had everything under control. It wasn't a problem for them in the game, apart from a couple of misplaced passes. They got counter-attacks, but being close to them, I could see they were really in control of the game, and they had a real belief in what they were trying to do, and stayed above the anxiety of the crowd, which is obvious. We're all getting, a lot of people are getting anxious of that, that you pay your ticket for, and that's part of the emotions that you get when you watch a football match. But they stayed above it, stayed doing the things they want to do, and I generally felt we would score, no matter what the time was.
Chcel by som vás poprosiť o zhodnotenie zápasu. Už zápas ste videli a pravdu povediac, ja som necítil žiaden stres. Myslím si, že sme nemali problémy. Bol som tam blízko a možno, že okrem niekoľkých horších prihrávok, vždy som videl, že sme mali zápas pod kontrolou, že si naši hráči veria. Samozrejme, že diváci boli napätí, ale to k futbalu patrí, pretože tam sú emócie, keď pozeráte na ten zápas. Ale ako hovorím, ja som v strese nebol. Myslím, že sme to mali pod kontrolou.
How much do you feel the game changed with the introduction of Chris Martin?
It was time to change. It was time to change. We had to change after when they got a man sent off. Took us about 10 minutes to readjust to that, understand what was needed at that point. And the longer the game went on, the stronger we got, and we just felt it was time for Chris to come on. We tried playing round and round the sides. We were getting a lot of that. There's times where you need Chris's power there, because really, if you look at them, they're a right powerful side, big people, with good technique, so that can be a problem at times. So we needed Chris on, and I thought it was terrific when he came on.
Ako si myslíte, že zápas zmenilo striedanie, keď prišiel na ihrisko Chris Martin? Myslím si, že bola potrebná táto zmena. My sme sa prispôsobili samozrejme aj vývoju zápasu, keď Slovensku vylúčili hráča, a myslím si, že postupne ako prebiehal čas, tak sme boli silnejší a lepší. A k tomu prispel aj Chris Martin, pretože on je skutočne silný, mocný hráč. A keď sa pozriete na Slovensko, oni majú takýchto hráčov, ktorí sú aj technicky veľmi dobrí, a celkovo výkon Chrisa Martina bol skvelý.
In terms of the late win, in terms of the euphoria that surrounded it, that everyone can feel still around this place, what might that do psychologically? Or what do you hope that does psychologically going into Sunday?
Everyone makes you feel better about yourself. Everyone, and the performance makes you feel better about yourself. So the goalkeeper was outstanding. Crossbar wasn't too bad either. So there was a lot going on that we can be pleased with. Then we have to regroup and go again.
Čo si myslíte o tej eufórii, ktorá ešte stále tu trvá, aký má psychologický dopad? Myslím si, že nám pomáha cítiť sa lepšie, podať lepší výkon. Myslím, že náš brankár zahral výborne, potom aj tie nastrelené brvná boli fajn. Čiže áno, je tu veľa vecí, s ktorými môžeme byť spokojní, ale teraz treba sa sústrediť na ten ďalší zápas.
You must have gone through a range of emotions during that game with the saves, the crossbar. Mm. Did you always see that goal coming?
I did, yeah. There's many times I felt like that the goal has not come, but I did feel it was going to come. I just felt that the work they put in, the way they try to play, a goal was coming for them.
Určite ste zažívali počas zápasu rôzne emócie, najmä pri tých nastrelených brvnách. Cítili ste ten gól vo vzduchu? Áno, pravdu povediac, ja som vedela, cítil, že skôr či neskôr to príde, že si to aj zasluhujeme za ten výkon, ktorý sme podali.
Okay.
So often we've come so close, Gordon. Tonight it's kind of been a long time coming, a result like that, hasn't it? And perhaps a little bit of luck as well at the end.
I thought the match Slovenia was good. That was good. So against England was good. So we've been building up to that kind of performance. Lithuania was just excellent. Malta was workmanlike. So we've been building up to that. The players have been building up to a performance like that. And they've been building up to it, and they deserve a performance like that. They deserve a result like that. As many times we've been sitting here with bad luck written all over it. But it wasn't bad luck tonight. It was a super goalkeeper, crossbar, and having a lot of chances, but eventually got one in.
Častokrát sme boli tak veľmi blízko a veľmi dlho sme možno čakali na takúto situáciu a tiež na trochu šťastia. Pravdu povediac, ja si myslím, že sme k tomuto smerovali s dobrým výkonom od zápasu k zápasu. Či to bolo proti Slovinsku, potom proti Anglicku, zlepšovali sme sa proti Litve, proti Malte. Čiže myslím si, že sa to čakalo a že si to aj zaslúžime, takýto výsledok za svoje výkony. Častokrát sme tu sedeli, bohužiaľ nemali sme šťastie, ale teraz mali sme skvelého brankára, potom aj tie Brná a nakoniec nám to tam padlo.
Gordon, a difficult group. I'm guessing you might well have taken second place with one game to go. Would that be right? And how do you rate the achievement of getting to that position now, given the start that you had?
Would have taken it, yeah. Because England are so far ahead of us with resources, but we showed against them that we can compete at times. What we ought to do now is try and finish this off, forget about bits and bobs went on before and just carry on from there. Bits and bobs, I don't know what you put that down in.
Don't worry.
Sorry about that, bits and bobs.
This and that.
Bits and bobs.
Je to dosť ťažká skupina. Akceptovali by ste to druhé miesto teraz ešte vlastne, keď zostáva ten posledný zápas a celkovo ako hodnotíte to, že možno teda dosiahneme to druhé miesto napriek tomu, že začiatok kvalifikácie nebol veľmi dobrý? Pravdu povediac, ja to beriem, pretože samozrejme Anglicko je ďaleko pred nami, čo sa týka prostriedkov, ktoré majú, ale teraz sa musíme sústrediť ešte na to, čo nás čaká, aby sme to dokončili.
Gordon, your opposite number was very aggrieved at the sending off. What was your take on it?
I don't know. The referee's made a decision. Get on with it. It was like the decision we had over there when Stephen Fletcher was rugby league tackled. And we just had to accept it. We walked away from it, accepted it and got on with it. So, times things go for you, things don't go for you. But the referee seems a capable referee.
Váš slovenský naprotivok nebol veľmi spokojný s tým vylúčením. Čo si o tom myslíte? Nož pravdu povediac, je to rozhodnutie ako každé iné. A my tiež možno sme mohli si niečo myslieť vtedy, keď doslova takým rugbyovým spôsobom šiel k zemi Stephen Fletcher. A musíme takéto rozhodnutie jednoducho akceptovať. Niekedy vám niečo vyjde, niekedy nie a rozhodca je súčasťou hry.
OK. Is that all right? Thank you. Thanks very much.
Ďakujem.
Craig, don't cut me some.
Thank you.
Thanks very much. Thank you.
Thank you.